Hello, ladies and gentlemen, yet another time. I'm back for episode 4, and I figured out how to build this coke oven. So the only difference between the coke oven from Railcraft and the coke oven from Immersive Engineering is that the Railcraft version has a hole in the middle, so like in this layer, the middle one is not there. And the Immersive Engineering one is just like three rows of blocks. So 9 by 9 as a 9 blocks bottom, 9 blocks middle, and 9 blocks on the top, and then right click it with your hammer. I don't have one on me, the Immersive Engineering Engineer's Hammer or something it's called. So yes, between episodes I started to cook some coal coke. Yeah, the block of coal, turn it into coal coke. I got some creosote oil. I've been extracting it manually with this bucket. Just put it in there and it dumps it into the bucket, and you get the bucket of creosote oil out. And I just put it into this hardened portable tank for storage purposes. And yeah, so we have 4 blocks of coal coke, and we can convert it into coal coke. Times 9. So yes, very good. What else have I done between episodes? I've been, of course, harvesting walnuts and these things down there. So I have a bunch of food. I'm cooking some more in here. So all that is very well managed. And I also made some gears. I made some gold gears, which we will turn into a assembly table just now. So if we look into the assembly table recipe, assembly table, here we have it. Where is the red? Yeah, there it is. Some redstone and some diamonds, and that's it. And yeah, the obsidian we already harvested. So three there. Oh, before that, we need to make some diamond gears, of course. One diamond gear and obsidian. There. A bit of redstone, a diamond, and a diamond gear. And we have an assembly table. Nice. This assembly table we'll put down somewhere. Yeah. Just for now, we will put it into this chest. The other thing we will need for the assembly table to work is power, and that's what I will be working on today. So normally, you need the coal co the coal coke for the blast furnace. So if we look into this, the blast furnace from Immersive Engineering, I think requires coal coke to cook the iron into steel. But we will use the blast furnace from IC2, which yeah, we will need the assembly table for. So there's not much need for the coal coke, other than the burn time. So it's double the burn time of normal coal. And yeah, it just will take time to produce it. So it's simply a matter of how quick do we need the burn, the fuel for of the coal. So if we have patience, we can turn all our coke into coal coke and get double the uses out of it. Which is very useful because the first generator we will be heading for is the survivalist generator. Survivalist generator, some iron gears, furnace, two furnaces at that, some coal blocks. Let's see how many we can manage to craft. I hope we can manage 6. Yes, we can manage 6. Very good. Two of them, then we need a chunk of cobblestone. Probably won't be enough. 5, 12, no. One furnace we can get. We need a bunch of them more. I mean, for now, we could use this one. Let's see. Do we have the time for that? Yeah, you know what? We will just use this for the time being. That's almost finished. Yes, it is. And head on from there. We have these three, so for now we will be using these until I get another furnace. So let's break this again. So we have two furnaces. We need an iron gear. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's throw that into the smeltery. Let me out of here. Thank you. 4 and the gear cast. And what else do we need? A piston, which is pretty easy to craft. Piston, we will need one of these. And we will need a piece of iron, a piece of this, and some wood. Just like that. The third piece, yes, there it is. like this. This is the piston, and then we have the generator like this. We need some redstone, I believe. Yes, two pieces of redstone. And that should be that. And once we have this Savalas generator, we can use coal coke to fuel it, which is, like I said, twice as efficient as the normal coal. So we will be producing power with it, and this power we will be using to create the steel in the steep gen, like the blast furnace from IC2. So, walnuts, put them in there. There we have our first Savalas generator. Nice. Let's see. I will be putting this down like there, I believe. There's as good a place as any. Let's see. Let's grab a piece of coal. Oh, and let's convert one into a block. And let's see how much power we get out of it. I hope I can use this in the Savalas generator. I mean, I don't see a reason why we shouldn't be able to. Yes, generates 1.6 burn time. Let's throw this. Okay, we can't use the blocks. Okay, whatever. Just for comparison, this generates, yes, half the amount. This will produce 160, which will fill up the buffer just fine. Okay, so I will be wasting some power unless we can manage to get a energy cell by then. So let's see. Energy cell, what's involved in that? Let's do an energy cell. We can craft this. Okay. Electrum, yes, we can do this. So gold, silver, two redstone, we need a block of redstone, of course. So 9 pieces. Then we need some lead, we have some glass, we don't, but we can manage that. Let's, for example, throw this in there. 4 pieces should be enough. Let's make some electrum. Yeah. We're getting somewhere. Ingot cast. Making some electrum. What's this doing? I mean, the thing is with the Savalas generators, luckily the buffer is taking some time to fill up, so I believe we will be able to complete our leadstone energy cell by the time this is finishing. So, electrum, thank you very much. Electrum ingot, yes, we turn that into the coil. Thank you. Some glass. Oh, we should have put this in there. Some lead. And then we craft a block of redstone with some glass, and then we have to wait for the lead. Very good. And then we can store the energy of the Savalas generator in the cell, so we can, like, two or three pieces of coal coke. We can throw in 3 pieces of coal coke in there, and that should be good. Okay, so next up, we will need a laser for this assembly table to work. So the laser requires us to have these diamantine electron tubes, and these are crafted as follows in a thermionic fabricator. So next step, thermionic fabricator. Sturdy casing, some gears and some ingots, some gold and a gold chest. So I made ahead of time 4 pieces of these. And the bronze I haven't finished just yet. So let's, for example, grab a few more of these and get to work. Very good. One piece of lead, two pieces of lead. We could, for example, also use the what's involved in the heat generators. Heat. We have the radioscope fluid heat, solid heat, electric heat. The electric heat generator. A battery. Electronite. Okay. That's involved into the in these. An item casing we should be able to do. Whoops. This should be easy enough. The heat conductor. Yeah, we could probably be using the electric one because with immersive engineering you can turn RF into EU. And we could use that. I think I will be going for that. That seems legit. So let's put this out of there so we don't clog up our dear little. This is running out. Very good. So, waiting for the bronze. Eight. We should have gone for a ninth. So we can pop it out into one giant basin. Okay. And by the way, the sword is doing a very good job of killing mobs that try to kill me. For example, this skeleton here. There's no skeleton. Why is there no skeleton? There it is. Come on. Die. Thank you. By the way, I usually go for the longsword, in case you're wondering, because I like to do this little trick where you charge up your jump and then jump, and then you fly quite the distance, and it's faster to travel this way than by sprinting or sprint jumping or something. So, sturdy casing was like this, yes. So, let's see, do we have enough gold? We could. See, thermionic fabricator needs the gold chest, three pieces of glass we should have. Yes, we do. The gold chest could be a problem, so we need eight pieces, and a hammer for the gold plates. Yes, this will take up quite the few resources. So, 16 of iron as well. For these plates, and then we need a few planks for the chest, surrounded with iron plates for the iron chest, and then upgrade it to a gold chest. Okay, so sturdy casing in the middle, gold chest, there, and we should have a thermionic fabricator. Nice. Now, the only question I have is that the does this machine require power? I believe so. Yeah, it looks like it. Then add power on the bottom. Okay, yeah, power is flowing in. And I should check if I have enough resources to craft a bed. Because this is getting annoying. String. Can I have used this hemp, maybe? No, I can't. Oh, I can. Okay, I do have enough string. One piece, two pieces, and three pieces. Nice! What is in here? Three pieces, and one more piece of wood. Makes a bed, and now I can sleep through the night. By the way, I don't know what I wanted to say now. So yeah, we have a bed now. Let's check on our thermionic fabricator. This should have liquid glass in there. Nice. And now we take five diamonds and two pieces of redstone. One, two, three, four, five. Two pieces of redstone. And we should be golden. Or diamantine at that. This And that. Oh, yeah, you have to put it in there. Very good. That looked a bit funny. Okay. Now we need some obsidian, four pieces, and some redstone, I think. Quite a bit of redstone. And then you can do it like this. And produce two lasers. Very good. Now for the next step. These lasers. Oh, let me grab my. Yeah, come on. Grab my assembly table as well. These lasers have to be on top or right next to the assembly table. So how about I place the assembly table here and then make a little. For example, like this. Looks okay. That doesn't look okay. Okay. So, yes, I know I'm using my diamantine pickaxe, but like this. Yeah, that looks awesome. Are these drawing power? Yes, it does. Let's break it. All these forestry machines. Always drawing power, even if they are not using it, so not the best way of not the best way to do power them all the time. So we have two of these lasers. Let's power them up. For power, I will probably use the MV capacitors. What's called MV? These ones, Y connectors, some iron and some hardened clay. And some hardened clay I should have. Yes, I do. There we go. And the electrum wire coils. Electrum wire coil is some a treated stick and four electrum. So I should get three more pieces. That means two more gold and two more silver. Should get me four pieces. I should maybe get four pieces more. Five pieces more. Yeah, let's throw this induction in there so we can, as I said before, so we can pour it out into the basin. That will be quicker that way. We have another block of cocoa. Nice. Let's grab a chest. And once we have this assembly table working, we can hopefully, let's say hopefully, we can hopefully make enough machines to automate some wood and coal production and stuff. So yeah. Let's throw this in here and let's put the chest there. So the assembly table normally outputs into a chest nearby. Let's maybe put it on behind there, like this. Yeah, looks awesome. So MV wire connectors. Let's connect them up like this. There's the output there, and now all we need is our electrum, which we'll be able to get in the casting basin. Mining goods, very good. There we go. Now we can make some electrical wire coils. Make it stick. Crafting table. And electrum wire coils. Two. That's all we need. So they made this also more. Whoa. Oh god, that was scary. Come here, come here. Give me an ender. There are you. these are getting power. Very good. Okay, so all we need to get now is two of these chipsets. Let's get two for the time being. One, two, iron chipsets. One laser. Two lasers. Nice. And this is probably, yeah. Not enough power gen. As I thought. So, yeah. I will take a short break now. I will be getting more of these Solaris generators. I will be mining a chunk of coal and cobblestone. And hopefully manage to finish three more of these Solaris generators to power my assembly table. So yeah, see you in just a second.
No.
So I've made a second Solaris generator, and then I realized maybe I should go for something else. Two Solaris generators should be a good start. I mean, my coal production is very much going. This is, yeah, about halfway finished. The power output of these two isn't really enough to get this going really fast. So I want to speed things up. And to do that, it will probably be a good idea to go for a bit of a faster generator. And I figured, why not go for the SE2-1. The SE2, normal, plain old generator with an iron furnace. I mean, this is about 10 iron, and then we have one furnace, which we can do. Then six more iron and some tin, electronite, and insulated tin cable. So the first limiter is, of course, cobblestone. So mining cobblestone is very bothersome, and I don't really like doing it. So I decided to use my last three diamonds for the following. So let's make this a diamond pickaxe. And four gold. Oh, and then we don't have lapis. Okay, so let's throw this in here. And what I want to go for is a world interaction upgrade. So the world interaction upgrade normally requires you an iron pickaxe, but in this case, a diamond pickaxe. Some lapis lazuli. And we should get a world interaction upgrade. And with this and an item transfer node, we can create a cobblestone generation thing. Item. Oh, is it called transfer node items? I think yes. Transfer node, this one. So this we should be able to craft, and then we need the world action upgrade. So I will be going mining. I also need some electronite and stuff. So yeah, probably a good idea anyway. Let's repair this and let's go mining. So I just wanted to give you guys a quick update. This is still not done at all. Yeah. So again, I will be making a cut and I will be come back once I have enough. I hopefully have enough lapis to finish our world interaction upgrade and make a transfer node. And from there, we will be able to make cobblestone on our own and not have to mine it. So yeah, see you in a second. Look at what I found. I haven't found any lapis yet, but some dark steel, nice. Nether quartz, a division sigil. Awesome. Very awesome. Something spawned. A steel sword, usable for crafting only. Yeah, I don't care about that. And the mega rubber sapling. Oh god. Very nice. So yeah, what to throw away? The dirt. The tin ingots we can use. The redstone also. And enderpearl dust. Yeah, why not? It seems a little more expensive than the arrow. So yeah, cool, very cool. We have found some more useful things in this loot thing, in the loot chests, and also I found another entry to my ravine. So maybe we will use the spawner later. For now, I will continue mining, and yeah, just wanted to show you guys what I found. By the time
No.
I found my 63, my 63 lapis, I found some gold ore berry bushes, some copper ore berry bushes, a ton of iron ore berry bushes, which is very good because yeah, iron you will always need, and you will need a lot. And yeah, I found some diamonds, electronite, a ton of redstone, gold ore. I mean, yeah, experience bushes I also found. So about that experience and other stuff, I doubt we will ever need anything anymore. So yes, I kind of feel like we are set for the night. Next few mining trips, I doubt I will go mining in the near future. So let's make another chest to dump all this stuff. I will plant these bushes in just a second. I just want to finish this real quick. So yeah, we have the world interaction upgrade. Let's grab a bit of cobblestone. We don't have any cobblestone. Okay, we need two pieces. Two. So that's all I get. Let's grab something to burn, like these stairs. Let's grab some wood, four more wood to make a chest. Like this. Very good. Oh, we will need three more pieces. I forgot. So, thank you. Throw this in here. This palm wood will also burn, I think. So, two pieces for the this. And we need some redstone and some glass. And that should be that. Three. Let's craft one of these. One set of these, rather. A piece of, like the block of redstone. Oh, and we don't have any fuel. Let's burn crafting tables because we have too many of them. Okay. I'm excited. I'm excited. We will get a cobblestone generation. It's very good. Two pieces. Thank you. So, one, two. A chest, a block, this, and that. Item transfer node. Pretty good. So, like before, let's set it up over here. Somewhere like there. One, two, three. And let me grab a bucket of lava. And they should combine into. Okay. I failed. Luckily, we have some extra buckets. And we never have enough obsidian anyway, so yeah. I will act like this was intended. So again, a piece of lava. And we should probably put a piece of cobblestone in between. That's how it should work. So let me grab that real quick. Then I got this bad boy, piece of cobble, and a item interaction upgrade. And we are producing cobblestone. Oh, very nice. So next step, a barrel. I hope you Java barrels work. Java barrel. Yes, they do. Wood. Chest. Cobble gen? Yes. Very nice. Okay. So with this cobblestone we are generating from our transfer node, we should be able to make some more furnaces. So how about I craft some more of this and plant this and chop it down? Mega rubble sapling. So let's like plant it out there. And then grab some gunpowder, like the blaze powder, gunpowder, bone meal. Great. This plus a mega rubber sapling should make more for enough rubber for days. Oh god! Oh my god! This is huge! Oh my god! So yeah, we should have enough rubber for centuries. I will just get a few pieces of rubber, and the rest I will just leave there for now and harvest it whenever I need it. So yeah, and we also have a second one of these, so yeah. Rubber should never be a problem again. What is this? Okay, just a little bug. Put this in there, rubber. So, how about I cook you? So huge. More. And we should be able to craft a furnace. We are. And now, the normal generator from IC2. The iron furnace we should be able to manage. So that's exactly enough for the furnace, the iron one. Plus the three we need here, and then we need an RE battery. So, tin cable, we need a cutter. Oh, yeah, okay. The cutter we should be able to make. No, we are not. Oh, we have some ore berries. Maybe that's enough. Probably not, but hey, with the shot. Nah, it's good. Nah, it's not enough because we need more of the other things. One more, because now we also need two ingots, which is pretty expensive for these plates. Cable, yes. Thank you. Let's grab some rubber. Make tin cables. We will need a few of these anyway, so in the future for our RE batteries. Forge hammer, tin plate. The item casing and electronite. There we have it. Two of these, an item casing and a battery. And then we need some more iron. We should be able to get. But yeah, I like our situation. Let's throw this in here. Sleep in my inventory is a mess. Yeah. Since I'm probably ending the episode in just a few minutes, I won't bother cleaning it up. Okay. So this is still outputting? No, it's not. Okay. Very nice. We should probably make a few more of these. So we. Is this okay? space in. We should make a few more of the chipsets because we will probably need them in the future. Oops. They will take a time to make, so why not just make them now? Okay. That looks to me like a few bug because it's not draining power. You can see it here. The energy cell is getting fuller and fuller, and yeah. So that's probably just a glitch. We have iron. We have iron. I said. Yes, we have. Now with the forge hammer, we make some plates, and with plates we make a generator. Let's see. This generator I will put down here, and then I will connect this generator with the MV wire connectors to this energy cell, and then we should be very well set early game power gen wise. So yeah, let me check the episode length real quick and then I will be back or just with an outro. So yeah, just a second. And I'm back. So yes, I was right. The first segment was very long and yeah, if you don't like longer segments, please let me know in the feedbacks, like the comment section below. Last episode was very long, I apologize for that, and on that note, I will end this episode here and not much talk about next episode. Yeah. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the episode, I hope you liked my progression here. Next episode, we will be for sure making some steel, and yeah. So, hope you enjoyed this episode, and see you all around.